Broadcasting live from the Vile Stadium in San Fransicko, home of the 40 Nightmares. You know why this team is named that? Because their fans are known to wake up in a cold sweat screaming at the top of their lungs. I don't blame them.
Don't poke fun at their city, Grim. Plenty of great places to eat if you like vegan.
Hey, I love to eat vegans, but they always whine when you're cooking them.
And today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams are taking the field. The Grim Bay Attackers battle the San Fransicko 40 Nightmares. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Hey, man, you see that? That's right. You can't handle this. You can't handle what I got. Yeah, get the hell out of here, man.
Grim Blitzrow with you along with my partner, former player Brickhead Mulligan.
Hi.
And his life partner, the mini mutant head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
Hey, you just threw up on my shoulder.
I don't often drink beer, but when I do, I get totally shit-faced. I am the world's most intoxicated man.
Say that again. And it's first and ten. And he's... Oh, nice hit! Second down and five. And this guy is on fuego. And they stack the line and he gets his bell rung for a yard. Third and four. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the QB. Oh, wow. If you're a defender, the only good QB is a dead one, Bricks.
Ah, he must be pretty good then, because he is dead.
And it's first and ten. With the brain scrambler. Second down and six. Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and ten. That would have been a disappointing run. It's even a worse throw. Second down and nine. And that's a great 9-yard completion there.
Hey, it ain't great if you don't score or move the chains.
And that'll bring up third down and inches. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
First and two. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And that'll bring up second and one. Third down and three. Dirt sandwich.
Jeez, I could make a kick that easy.
Hell, I could make a kick that easy, and I didn't even have feet.
He's got about the distance, and the kick is good. Well, that's a strange penalty called right there.
I'm starting to notice that this ref likes talking, and it don't make much sense.
No, but he's making a lot of dollars.
If they don't pick it up, and they've had enough, the offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. Now this one's gonna be tough. I hope he has a good enough leg for this one.
I saw him trying one on before the game. He looked okay, I think. Not my type, though. A little too noodle.
Then looked at the QB's fault. If he held the ball spikes out like it was supposed to, the kicker would have never missed.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, with the punishing hit. And it's first and ten. Second down in a mile. Well, that was a good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
Third down and never gonna happen. Toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
The 20. The 10.
He scores!
Kickers, you never know. And the easiest play in the league, and he chokes.
Yeah, he's a choker.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game. And it's first and ten. That's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and 7. Tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a console wasn't home.
3rd and 2. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth. Yep. 3rd grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. 1st down. It's 1st and 10. And he rumbles for 9 on that play. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1.
See, this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. Defense. Of course, he could have had an interception, returned it for a touchdown, and changed the entire game, but I don't want to nitpick. And he zips that one in there for a touchdown. At some point, they're going to need to put this ref out of his misery.
How about now, for instance? Here's a hit. Dirty tricks. Attack the ref.
Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Oh, and the ref just bought himself one more play of life with some moves that would put some of our Hall of Famers to shame.
Oh, good. That gives me time to get odds on him. Someone give me a phone.
Third down, and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. QB is saying his prayers. That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
The offense just burned the defense pretty hard on that one.
Man, it's still edible, though. Just gotta scrape off the charred parts. Well, I once saw a kicker make a kick like this with his extra leg. He used it like a golf club.
That wasn't a leg, you moron. That was tripod jack.
Well, surprise me. He made it look easy, and he gets 3 points for it. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. It's 1st and 10. Second down in a very lot. They pick up a nice chunk of yards on that pass play. And that'll bring up third and one. 2 minutes remain in the half.
Wait, I gotta take a dump.
And that'll bring up third and one. And with a burst of speed, he finds an opening and the first down. And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
And it's first and 10.
You know, this berserk dirty trick ain't fair to the QB. It's like inviting an anteater to an anti-convalescent home.
Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Briggs. Thanks.
That's what she said.
Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. And it's first and 10. Point, but this guy could blow it. You have got to be kidding me. My sister could have made that kick. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. And that's a nice run for a first down. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least...
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
Great run for a 9-yard gain. And that'll bring... That's it. That's their last time out. It's them against the other team and the clock.
Well, that doesn't seem fair. I'm going to throw a hammer on the field and even the odds.
And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and 10. He got rid of it out of bounds. That's better than throwing a pick, I suppose. Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
Oh. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? Our carnival? Huh? I'm going to go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down and just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit.
Man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Second down and six.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
First and 10. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and 3. And that's how you run the football. First down. First and 10. I'm going to say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Second down and 7. Third down and 6. Oh, great play. He is on that receiver like glue.
You know, when I was little, my dad used to make me eat glue. My tongue would get stuck to the roof of my mouth, and I couldn't talk.
Your father was a very smart man, Bricks. Very smart.
Oh, and he misses the kick. And his teammates are going to flog him when he gets back to the sideline. And it's first and 10. He turned into a mutant fireball with that flame on dirty trick. And anything he touches gets floppy. And the ground game is starting to soften up the defense. First down. Now these penalties have really gotten out of hand, especially since they're fake.
Go to dirty tricks and hit attack ref. It feels good.
First down and long. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery.
Nobody likes to watch that happen to a ref.
Yeah, you got that right, Brickhead. They'd rather be down there in the field doing it themselves. A lot more fun. First down and a mile.
Yeah, because you're getting skipped.
Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. He is fighting for every yard. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. First and 10. Oh, and the defense jumps outside. If this guy could talk before he died, what do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck?
The offense has only two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. And it's first and 10. The way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. First down and 6. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Now the QB is dinking and dunking the defense to sleep. 1 yard on that pass. Second down and 9. This guy's a brick shot. Caught for the first down. First and 10. Good throw, good catch, but not quite good enough at 9 yards. And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive.
First down. This guy just loves to hit people as hard as he can, Grim. I don't even think he knows what a first down is.
First down and 6. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance now.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because it was too fast.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room.
You gotta be kidding me! My sister could have made that kick!
Isn't your sister in a wheelchair?
I know, right?
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not yawn.
Quarter three comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. And it's first and 10. Second down and ain't gonna happen, partner. And they went to the air and came up big. And that'll bring up third and one. Shoveled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. Second down in a mile. You can tell he's a berserker because he's frothing at the mouth.
Oh,
and that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 with the vicious kill.
Did you know light hits are one of the leading causes of death for mutants over 25?
I didn't know that.
Yeah, right below attending bachelor parties and owning a Sam Schwong Galaxy phone.
Third down and the punter is warming up. First down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Second down and long. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
Third down and 10. And he snags it for 6. Touchdown! They're going for 2 points. Well, that 2-point conversion attempt failed miserably. I mean, that was just terrible. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
First and 10. And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full on berserk.
Or at least he could set himself on fire. At least that would slow the berserker guy down.
Second down and a lot. The quarterback has had enough and calls a murder ball dirty trick to lay waste to the defense. base hit. And it's first and 10. First down and one. Talking about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. And that'll bring up second and one. The fourth quarter, and we're at the two-minute warning.
2 minutes until what?
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily.
Season, dumbass.
Actually, I think he's talking about the time warp dirty trick that the defense just played. Still a dumbass, though. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. And this guy couldn't hit the side of a fallout shelter. The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Stealing ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
Since he's a kicker, that brings him up to a one-hole highlight. And it's first and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with two in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
First down! He hit that line the way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose hits him.
The timeout is called by the quarterback. They have one left. First and four. Okay, nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. Gets 3 yards on that run. The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And he sends into the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
First down, and they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
And the running game is starting to click now. A pickup of 8 on the play. And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
And that'll bring up 2nd and 1. And he runs it in for the touchdown. Either way, they're going for 2. And he plows forward for the 2-point conversion. They need a good return here to set up the offense. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. 2nd down and 6. And that's the last time out. They can't stop the clock anymore.
Can any of us really stop the clock, Grim? I mean, when it comes right down to it, are we not all united by the constant reminder of our own mortality? Of death's constant, relentless advance? If only it was as easy as telling them time out to stop our own clock. You know, Grim?
Truer words never spoken, my friend. The 49ers lose the game. And the hometown crowd is getting uglier than a dollar store hooker right now. They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was beautiful. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by the Exxon Oil Corporation.